Now, let's go ahead and jump into a quote. Inside our quoting tool, this is going to be a three-step simple process to take you from quoting, returning rates with all of your carriers in one central repository, to take you straight to dispatch. This is about a 1 minute, minute and a half quote to dispatch process, which is a really fast way to really speed things up and help you do business more efficiently when going through a quote. You're going to have your origin located on the left-hand side, destination on the right. A few things you'll notice though, at the top above my origin, it's going to say volume. You have the ability to run a volume quote as well. Only difference between running a volume and LTL quote is that a volume quote requires the linear feet, how much room it's going to take up on that trailer. Once you have your linear feet set and inside, you can then move it forward. But we're going to go ahead and stick with an LTL quote first. If I need to adjust the pickup date, I can adjust it right here on the calendar. If I'm going to be running a prepaid outbound shipment, we have it set as by default as that. If I need to run an inbound collect shipment, we also have the capability to do that as well. All you do is select inbound collect. It'll flip-flop the origin and destination to now where you're receiving the freight, and you will need to fill out the shipper details. If we need to run a third-party rate, all you simply do is hit third party, fill out what it's shipping out of and where it's going to, and you will be the third party billing address. When looking up the destination, there's a few ways to look up a destination inside the system. One can be off your address book. If we have a list of your customer locations inside the address book, we can just type in a few letters. It'll pull up that address to then fill out and preload on the whole quote. Or we can look it up by city, state, or zip code to generate for you. My favorite tool to utilize when looking up an address is to switch it from lookup over to Google Maps. By doing that, we can look up a full company's address just off the company name. By typing in just a few letters of that company name, I can find the account I'm looking for, select it, and then it'll fill out the full address for me. On the right-hand side, you'll notice a little Google mapping button. You can click that to get a satellite view to see exactly where you're shipping to. If you want to take it a step further to determine whether it needs a liftgate, if it's limited access, residential, you can even take this little guy, drop him out on the street, and see for yourself where you're shipping to determine so you're not getting dinged for any accessorial charges. Once that is set, now I can add in my accessorials. To add in your accessorials, they're going to be located underneath the destination as well as the origin. By clicking on the plus button, we can have a dropdown of each and every accessorial we need to include onto that rate. If it's going to be a residential shipment, you can select residential on the right-hand side next to business, trade show, non-commercial as well. Once we have our accessorials and where it's going to established, we can now go down to the commodity description. With this commodity description, this is where our product list that we entered in comes to life. I click on my commodity line, it'll generate my product for me. I select my product, and then it'll preload what I already had set in there. Package type, dimensions, commodity description, and class. Only thing we need to add in as well is just a total weight. Once you have your total weight set, you are good to move to the next step. If we need to add any additional commodities, we simply just hit add commodity. And that's in case it has the same dimensions. If it has different dimensions, all we're simply going to do is hit add handling unit and plug in our next commodity accordingly. If you are unsure of what your class is for this rate to make sure you're not getting any reclassification charges, we do have an open density calculator to determine the suggested freight class for you. To find where your open density calculator is, that's going to be located down at the bottom of the screen on the first step by saying open density calculator. From here, all we simply do is put in our dimensions, a weight, and it'll give us our suggested freight class, density, and volume. Once we have our class determined, we select our class and we move forward to the next step. If I need to insure my shipment, I can add in my cargo value down in the bottom corner. By adding in this cargo value, it'll then apply that insurance charge onto the next step. By going to the next step, all you simply do is hit select carrier. When you hit select carrier, it'll now take you to your carrier rate selection. On this carrier rate selection page, it's going to have each and every carrier you have direct pricing with that's integrated, filtered by transit time. You'll see we have a 2-day and a 3-day lane for my list of carriers, all in a standard guaranteed AM or PM rate return. I can click on the cost of any one of these carriers. It'll then give me my lane type, if it's direct, indirect, my quote number, my reference number to determine whether or not that is a direct rate I am getting from my carrier with my pricing, and then last, the grand total. To get a price breakdown, you click on the cost one more time. It'll show each and every item charge as well as any accessorials associated. If you were to insure your shipment, it'll also show the insurance charge as well. If we need to print, download, or email this rate return to a different department, we can do it right from this page here. If I need to save my quote, we also have a reference ID tool to save my quote, so that way I can pick up where I left off at any time during the day. I'm going ahead and save my quote as the company name, and I'll hit the little checkmark button. I'm also going to favorite this quote as well, because this is going to be a repeat customer that I'll be shipping to frequently. Now, if I need to step out of the office, I click my logo, go back to my calendar. If I need to jump back in to my quote, we can access that in the toolbar in our quote history tool. Inside the quote history tool, this will have unlimited quote history showing each and every quote you have ever pushed through the system. If I need to pick up where I left off or jump back into an old quote, you have the ability to do that. We can filter it through by reference ID. And located all the way on the right-hand side will be these three dots. By selecting these three dots, I can open my quote and pick up where I left off. If I want to favorite these quotes, we can filter it out by the favorite tool as well. Locating the star up in the top left-hand corner, I click it, and I can find each favorited quote I have. To then, same thing, go to the right-hand side, open up my quote, and pick up where I left off. Now, as you can notice, you'll see there is going to be a little green shield letting you know that you are rating this quote with insurance. If we want to turn that off, we simply just slide it over to the left. It'll then adjust our rates without the insurance charge. Once I find the rate that I want, all I simply do is hit select. By hitting select, this will take me to my final step, again, prompting me to insure my shipment.